got that, what would be the impact on the city and on schools?
Good afternoon, my name is Jane Ferrara, and I'm with Economic and Community Development at City of Richmond. The question of valuation is, as it relates to this property, is an interesting one, because the value ultimately would be and will be determined by the outcome of the property, ultimately how somebody intends to develop it. Any developer that is evaluating a property to acquire will base it on, again, how they develop it and what their return on that investment would be. So let's look at the assessed value. The assessed value of this 6.5 acre parcel and 60,000 square foot building together is $7,559,000. So when you break that out, there's a portion of value that's assigned to the land, and there's a portion of the value that's assigned to the improvements. In this case, the land value for 6.5 acres is $2,839,000. That's $435,000 per acre. The improvement value based on the assessment is $4,720,000. That's for a 63,000 square foot structure that has two floors, and a third of the square footage is underground in a basement. So what we are discussing with Bon Secours in this transaction is a lease of 4 acres of the 6.5 acres to Bon Secours. And that 4 acres does in fact include the improvements. Now, the other thing that factors in to the valuation of a property is zoning. In this case, the property is zoned R4, which is single family residential. In order for Bon Secours to develop this property to the extent that they wish to develop it for medical office types of space, that would require a special use permit process. As Mr. Marshall said, that can take 6 to 7 months with no guarantee. That factors into value. So let's look at a couple scenarios that might bring it into perspective. So a speculative office developer, for example, if an office developer were acquiring land in an office park in a region, they would likely pay $250,000 per acre. So for 4 acres, that would translate to about $1 million. If you look at industry standards for construction, an average office building would total about $13 million in development value after the completion of the building. Based on that value, the real estate taxes would be $157,000. In a retail scenario, for 4 acres and to accommodate the parking, you could probably get 40,000 square feet of retail space on the site. And let's be really optimistic. Let's say that this retailer would pay $1 million an acre. But let me back up on that just a minute. The retailers that pay the most for ground are gas stations, fast food, and drug stores. And I think, as we've all read and we've all heard, it's not uncommon that those types of users will pay a premium, sometimes $1 million an acre. So given that scenario, if the property were sold at $1 million an acre, you'd get $4 million. Those types of uses are not going to retain the existing improvements in that site. They need to maximize that site for retail space. We estimate they could accommodate 40,000 square feet of space on that site. They would likely, based on RS means, spend $150 per square foot to construct the building, which would be a $6 million investment, which would generate $72,000 in real estate taxes. The jobs that would likely be created for this type of use would be part-time and, in often cases, minimum wage. I'm sure all of you all have heard from developers that are very interested in retaining the existing improvements and doing a tax credit deal. They're, most of the older buildings in the city right now are eligible for some very attractive tax benefits. In these scenarios, the developer is going to price the property according to the number of units that they could build within the envelope of the existing building. In this case, a 60,000 square foot building, again, being generous, a third of the space is in this basement space. But assuming that units could be created in all 60,000 square feet, and assuming a developer could get 60 units, let's say that developer would pay $50,000 per unit for that property. That developer might pay $3 million for that property. But here's the catch. If they leverage a tax credit type of development, their taxes would be abated. Also, in this particular scenario, it's not anticipated that new jobs would be created. Then, thirdly, or lastly, there's the case of a condo development, which would be high density. Again, we don't know the zoning, we don't know how many units you could get on 4 acres, but let's say for purposes of discussion, a developer could get 20 units per acre or 80 acres on the site. Their investment value could be anywhere from, you know, $150,000 to $200,000 per unit. It really depends on what the end price would be for each of those condo units. The real estate taxes could range anywhere from just under $200,000 to $250,000 as an estimate, but no new jobs would be created. Under the bond support scenario, bond supporters have said that they would develop 75,000 square feet of medical space on this site. They would invest $24 million in that square footage, and they would create 120 jobs with an annual payroll of $10.8 million. The question of, could we have gotten more money for this site? The answer is yes, we could. But there's another question, in my opinion, and that is, could we have gotten a better outcome? And I guess that's what you're here to decide.
Ms. Farmer, before you sit down, would you give me an idea how long that site's been vacant? And we have a lot of people wanting that property.
The property was declared surplus in 2009. And I'm sorry, what was the second question?
And we had a lot of people wanting, you know, what?
We've had many inquiries about the property since 2009.
But anything that you could work with? I mean, were they real estate inquiries?
We never entered into any negotiations with anybody.
Now, are we supposed to hear from bond securities at this point?